Where's the ones I gave you? Yeah, I gave you the lemon ones. You put them in your purse. There's the lemons. The lemon hulls are in your purse.
It's on my back.
You don't want to reach in there. Very hot out here today, folks. So, as I mentioned earlier, and I'm gonna mention it again, we are out here walking for Salish Seas, Tokatai, the whale orca that has been held in captivity for over 10 years now. And basically, we want to free, you know, there's two left. There's two orcas left. There's her mother and her, and that's it. There's no more. We don't have any more orcas left other than those two. So we need to feed them, you know, and we need to, like, let them go in the wild where they belong, you know. Oh, that felt good. Darn. Yeah, get us wet. We've been walking all day. Awesome. So we kind of got the guy over here to spray us. He's awesome. It's like, spray us, please. We've been walking all day.
Got a what?
Take a boat to go to Chase?
They gotta be closed now.
They close at 6.
But it's Saturday.
Oh, they close at 1 on Saturday.
Yeah, but you know those guys.
By the time we got over there, it'd be over.
There's no way they're open on Saturday.
They're open.
Oh,
water.
Where are we going? This way?
Yeah.
Straight across?
Yeah.
From your house to
somewhere.
Grandma!
Got it.
How much longer do you think that is?
Right there.
Let him get out right there and leave it.
Go to 231 and have him get out there.
Oh, the shit. Dang it. Spoke too soon. It only lasted for a second. This shit feels so good, though. Oh my gosh. I've been doing it for a while, so it's...
This guy is 6 miles backwards.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We're asking all the elders to move forward at this point in time and lead us to the end. Because, well, they are our elders. It's only proper for us to do that in our nation, in our culture. So we've asked all of the, whether they're indigenous or not, we've asked all the elders to come to the front and lead us in. Because, well, elders are elders. They have way more knowledge than we do for a reason. So all of our elders are leading us in. Thank these women in front here and all the other grandmas. Oh. So Roxanne's gonna sing the Women's Honor song for us.
When we get Kyle's in for the next one, we're waiting for the other groom because they're going to join us. So I'm going to say it.
Roxanne is teaching the
elders
the Women's Honor song. Over and over. Love Roxanne. Beautiful, beautiful woman. They're not stopping though. They stopped and then took off. They were in the white van. Yeah, but they missed their turn. I don't know why they went ahead.
They missed the message.
Yeah, they missed the turn and the message because.
Okay. So here we go. We're just gonna go.
Yeah. Thanks for the warning, Roxanne.
Sorry.
No, that is. It's hard when they're walking uphill. You got elders walking uphill, honey.
That's it.
Right here. You want me to jump in? I'm trying to get him to sing up, but it's just not working. Hey, Yakio! Way! Yakio! Yakio! Hey, Yakio! Yakio! Hey, Yakio! Yakio, yakio, hey, hey, yakio, yakio, hey, hey, yakio.
One last time.
Put the hands up.
Take that picture.
Yeah, for sure. I got you. right here. Folks, we're gonna do a water blessing. Probably go back to the church, eat dinner, and end the day. So, thank you for watching Independent Two Spirit Media today. With the rest of the crew.
Reading each other.
Eva, independent two spirit media.
Office, and they're still relying on us to give them the feedback that they need. They need that guidance to continue to do what they've been hired to do. And so that's the role that the activists have been playing on north of the border. And that's the role that I believe that we can do down here to say no to the pipeline. Because this pipeline right now, right where we're situated at, is critical. It's on the critical list. It will destroy this land if we don't do something now. But we have to do something more than just occupying the streets and more than just condemning the banking institutions. We have to go at this full fight, even if it means electing people that will go into the boardrooms and disrupt from within. So this is what we're doing. This is what we're doing north of the border, and this is what we need to be doing on this side. And so I spoke briefly to Kyle and Paul and Paris and a few people last night about having a direct action at the Peace Arch to unite our people on all sides of the border. And one of the questions that Paris had brought up to me last night is that, what if we get arrested? And I'm like, as one of the
exactly.
Activists, I'm like, which country would like me, first of all? I deserve to have arrested. They're kind of like, okay, so, but you know, it's like, we have a lovely Jay Treaty that has been written in the Constitution that guarantees all Indigenous people the rights to practice their traditions and crossing the border like our ancestors did. That's the trade. And I said, so that Jay Treaty, Section 35, is what protects us. We can cross the borders without a passport.
We're stuck on that border.
We just have to be a registered Indian. That's all the government needs to know about us. This is who we are. This is our territory. These are my relatives right here. As Indigenous person, we are one and one and one, and we can build that unity by having a demonstration of the Peace Arch, because at the Peace Arch is an international trip. That we share territory between the two countries. And that is a vital link for the pipelines. Right now, about 2 weeks ago, I learned that the pipeline, the LNG pipeline, is going to surround two-thirds of Victoria. So when it comes down from Haida Gwaii, it will come down through the Salish Sea, loop around Victoria. It will go to the port in Burnaby before it comes to Cherry Point. So the federal government has been building these ports, these emergency ports, on all the different reservations without consultation of the people that are looking after the land. And so we're like, okay, well, there's no way that this pipeline is going to go through. It's not going to go through because the people are starting to educate themselves. One and one and one and one. We have to make this an everyday dinner conversation. We cannot afford to be hiding this topic. I was sharing inside, I said that I'm the type of person that I like to talk about the IDEs and the ISMs. Let's talk about religion, sex, politics. Because those are the things that we were taught not to talk about. We need to talk about it because all these things contribute to the social injustice to our ancestors. So we need to start talking about the reasons why we don't want this pipeline. We need to start looking to the future. 7 and 8 generations ahead of the grandkids to come. We need to have this vision, and we need to say, I did my part. So I was putting on Facebook last night, I said that we need to press more than the like button.
Oh.
Yeah.
We need to say that selectivism, yes, Paul, is not acceptable without the action to follow.
Oh.
So we need to mobilize. We have proven to the world what we can do when we had the event at Standing Rock.
Yeah.
It was within hours of their plight to say, we're doing this. And then all of a sudden, like, thousands of people started showing up. And millions of people started paying attention to it on Facebook, on the social media.
Right.
We grabbed the attention of the entire world, just like we did with Idle No More.
Right.
Started with five women talking about the lack of inadequate housing, drinking water, health care. Five women started Idle No More. Within 36 hours, we were over 1 million plus. So, you know, like, we've proven to our governments we can do the things that they cannot do, because they use policy as a barricade. Oh, I can't do it because it's not in my jurisdiction. I use policy as a stepping stone. Something to step on because I want to get over there.
Woo!
We are changing the world. One on one and one. And so, all this experience that I share with you guys today is because this is what I've learned since the first time I stepped into the courtroom and challenged the Canadian government over my identity. Because when I was 14 years old, I was in the foster care system. And they were trying to make me a Canadian. They were trying to make me declare my citizenship. And I said, I am Coast Salish. This is who I am. This is in my DNA. So it's taken the government decades to figure out that I was born on the American side of the border, and I'm like, that's Coast Salish territory. Doesn't make any difference to me. So I've used that example of traveling back and forth over the border with the Jay Treaty without a passport and without a birth certificate for quite some time. So every time I come down here, the border guards always say, do you have your American passport? And I'm like, right here. So this is who I am. I am from Sliam, and I am Rose Henry, and I'm saying the time for the revolution is now.
As you guys can tell now, he's a huggy person, not a handshake. around the drummers. Everyone around the drummers. Well, they're walking.
Oh, she said round dance.
No, they're getting ready to start walking.
She told me that she wanted to.
Yeah, she does. But Paul's leading. So, Paul's leading. Paul said, everybody gather around the drummers and get ready to go. So that's what I told everybody to do. Split. Thank you. there quite a ways with the kid in. The kid's there too by himself. If you want me to, I can grab your keys, go in your truck real quick. You want me to go grab it? I'm just recording. Honor our treaties. Job. I got a media pass for a reason.
Drops our girl away.
You guys want to hit Macy's main entrance, or where do you guys want to hit?
That's our trailing vehicle. That vehicle saves our lives, sir. That's why we're here. We can't leave until that vehicle follows us.
What happened is our trail vehicle got pulled over. She was in the middle of the road helping us, like she has been for the past 2 days. She's got to make sure we're okay. You know, she's our trail vehicle. She's our lifeline. So we have to make sure she's okay. Because if she's not okay, we're not okay. That is our lifeline right here. She is our lifeline. Are you going to be trailing us right away, or is it going to take you a sec?
She's not going to take it right
away. Okay. Thank you. We'll start walking.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, gentlemen.